awesome way to start the show. DJ Fresh, Louder, One Radio, 92.7. It's TFI Friday. Good evening. I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
Ooh, again, we sing. I love it. I love it. You're always so happy.
I have a question about that song. Love the song. Was there something wrong with it at the end?
No, that's dance music, dear.
Oh,
dance music.
I just don't know.
Guess what?
Tell me.
It's Friday.
Hey!
All right, so it's been a long week, hasn't it?
It has been a long week this week.
I feel like it's been at least 3 weeks since last Friday for me, so there's been so much on.
You said that yesterday, and it feels like 10 years.
We have got loads coming up for you in the show tonight. We've got some new features as well. We've got Trudy's terrific tune.
Thanks.
Yeah, I know. It better be terrific, you know. We've got Paul's pucker tune, which will be better.
Thanks a lot. Is that because I'm a girl?
And we're going to be playing False or True D.
Hey, I see what you did there.
And of course, it's a Friday, so we're warming you up for the weekend. We've got loads of massive hits from the current chart, as well as some hits from a particular year we're calling the Year of Request, which today is
1990.
I was 3. 1990. I was -6. 1990 is our Year of Request today. So we've got a few particular hits from there as well, including this one. Know it?
Ooh. I do.
Yeah, number one in UK charts, Madonna and Vogue. All right, it's Friday night. Keep yourself entertained. Get in touch with the show, live@1.com.mt. And of course, we have an epic show for you with our very special guest. He's just arrived in his studio. I haven't even had a chance to say hello, but ladies and gentlemen, Joseph Calleja is with us this evening.
How exciting!
It is exciting. I know, crazy. We'll be talking to him very soon. It's One Radio. Good evening. Bit of Madonna for you then on a Friday night, just to get your vogue on.
I love her.
You love her, do you?
I love her.
You still think she's great now?
No.
Why?
She's way over there.
Jealous? How old is she? 45 or something?
She must be 50-something.
50-something, you think?
Yeah. And she looks pretty good.
She does look great for her age. But listen, let's forget about Madonna, because I'm fed up with that. It's Friday night. It's TFI Friday. Hi, I'm Paul.
And I am Trudy.
And we have a very special guest in the studio with us. We'd like to introduce you to the Maltese tenor, Mr. Joseph Calleja. Good evening.
Hello, good evening.
How are you today?
I'm fine, actually. I'm enjoying a couple of days here in Malta.
Yeah, because you're back fleetingly, aren't you?
Yeah,
tell us, when did you land? When did you get back here?
Well, literally, well, less than a week ago, actually.
Oh, right, okay.
I'm supposed to be abroad right now. I have a performance tomorrow, but I got
You've
the flu.
You stayed for us?
No. Well, for you as well, but actually, I've got the flu. I'm getting much better, but unfortunately, I wasn't, good enough to go and sing tomorrow.
Fair enough, fair
Did
enough.
You tell them you weren't coming?
Yeah, they know.
Okay, they're not just sitting there waiting. Quick. Someone stand up and sing.
We had a bit of a thing. We popped out to meet you last night, just before today's show, and had a chat with you, and you were saying, yes, I'm coming in. And then today we lost you completely. We didn't know where you were or whether you were coming in. We were like, please, Joseph, thank you for turning up and relieving us.
I'm glad I'm here.
Welcome to the show anyway. It's TFI Friday, and we're just trying to get everyone warmed up for a good night out. You're here fleetingly, as you said. You've got loads of news on at the moment, where you're going to next, possible film coming out, all this kind of stuff. We're going to cover all of that tonight. But okay. We'd also like to ask you some questions, which Trudy will do throughout the show. I'm hoping they're not too personal, you know, because she can get a bit like that.
Since when?
Since always, dear.
You're giving me a reputation.
No, you gave that to yourself.
Just because I'm blonde.
Oh, there we go again. Always with the excuse.
It's not my fault. I was almost born this way.
We're going to ask you later on, and I'll ask you now, Joseph, but don't answer now. Just have a think about it. We're going to play a request for you later in the show. It can be anything, as long as we've got it.
Okay.
So have a think about, like, which song you might want us to play. We're also going to play one of your songs, of course. And today, the guest, the year of request is 1990. And we've got... What were you doing in 1990?
I think trying to get rid of acne.
That was your main interest.
Yeah, it was probably my main preoccupation. Yeah.
So you're a teenager?
I was. I'm born in 78, so that makes me almost exactly a teenager. Well, almost. Yeah. I was 12.
12, 13, so, yeah, that's yeah, right. Because yeah, you're a couple of years older than me, I think. Yeah, that's right. I was 10, yeah. So I hadn't touched the acne. Acne problem.
Yeah. I wasn't born then.
You also, because you're only 17 yeah. now.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I mean, Trudy was in high school.
Let's play some more music. We'll get back to you shortly. Good evening. If you've just joined us, it's TFI Friday with me, Paul, and Trudy.
And Trudy, sorry, I'm making faces at Joseph. Right. Sorry about that.
And our very special guest, Joseph Calleja, is in the studio tonight. It's just after quarter past seven. Good evening. Hope you're having a good one. Icona Pop, I Love It For You on One Radio. Icona Pop, I Don't Care, I Love It. So do I.
That's nice.
Do you love it, Trudy?
I love it. I really want to say the rest of that sentence, but you can't say it on air.
Absolutely. It's One Radio 92.7. Good evening at TFI Friday. Hi, I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
And we're with Joseph Calleja. Good evening once again.
Hello.
Joseph, it's just very chilled out today. You're just like, yeah, cool, I'm in the studio. Big plans tonight, or are you just relaxing?
I'm kind of sick, getting
yeah,
better
of course,
from a cold.
Of course, yeah, because
so we'll have to go home and
yes,
drink,
yeah.
You know, chamomile tea with honey.
Does that mean you're Jeremy?
Jeremy, no.
Okay, that's good. I'm sitting quite close. I have a couple of questions for you. The first question would be, oh my goodness, I think I told everybody yesterday, you freaked me out this week.
Yes!
I was coming off the Gozo ferry and I get a call from the Inland Revenue. Now, everyone I've spoken to has commented on what a fun guy you are okay. and what a good laugh you are. And obviously you like pranking people. Thanks ever so much for that. I'm still trying to recover.
Because you hadn't spoken to Joseph
never
at this
before.
Point.
Sorry, yeah, to fill in the story, never spoken to Joseph before. He called me on Tuesday, I think it was. I was walking off the Gozo ferry and he told me he was the Inland Revenue. Brilliant. Now, I have just put in my tax return and Joseph then proceeded to tell me that there was a problem with it and would I please come in
Brilliant.
To see him at the Inland Revenue before they made fines and so on and so forth. Eventually, Joseph tells me actually it's Joseph Calleja, and then a rather large amount of expletives came out of my mouth, and everybody else who was coming off the Gozo ferry just sort of stepped back from me. But you're a big pranker joker. What do you do this very often? Do people do it to you?
Yeah, do people get you back?
Yeah.
For the pranks you play.
You have no idea what I've got lined up for you.
I have no idea what you guys are talking about.
Oh, get out of town.
Yeah, no chance.
But seriously, what's the biggest prank you've played on people?
No, seriously, I have no idea what you're talking
excellent.
About.
Excellent, okay, excellent. So. I'm going to move swiftly.
Yeah, cross that question out then.
Thanks ever so much indeed. Moving on to the next one. I'm really curious. So, if you're an athlete,
yeah.
which of course I am, you have to exercise. If you're, I don't know, if you're a politician, you have to do politics. You're a singer. Do you have to do stuff to
you have
your
to
voice?
Practice.
Do you have to sing in the bath and things?
Sometimes in the bath, but more often than not elsewhere. I think that singing is actually a type of sport. It's a type of athleticism because you use your whole body for singing. It's not just the throat and the vocal cords. And so you have to be in shape. You have to mm-hmm. be able to sing for 3 hours straight with no amplification, no microphone in the opera house.
Right.
So it is very much, I normally do run 3 times a week and at least lift weights 4 times a week as well. It's very important to keep in shape for, because it's physical and your whole instrument is the body. It's not just your larynx, not just your throat.
Right.
And, so you have to be in good physical shape, keep your immune system up, and the way you do it is by conducting as much as possible a healthy lifestyle.
And wow. I suppose, like you say, that you're a bit poorly at the moment and you've had to delay this gig you've got coming up. I suppose that's really important because can you break your voice? I mean, if you break your voice and you do perform while you're ill.
You can break your voice. There are some stuff, like I was ill last week
right.
in Vienna and the Classical Brit Awards in London. And I still managed to perform, but then there has to be some recovery. So unfortunately, it happens very rarely, but occasionally I also have to cancel some performances if I'm ill. Because if you sing when you're ill, you do risk to irrevocably damage your instrument, and that would be, of course, a big pity.
So, I suppose it's like going back to your analogy earlier, Trudy, a footballer spraining his ankle. Yeah, you know, he couldn't perform, you know, and if he did, it might damage him further.
It's exactly the same. That's a fantastic analogy. I mean, and, you know, the muscles that footballers use are actually much larger, much stronger than the vocal cords. The vocal cords, once you damage them, it's extremely difficult to get them functioning the way they were. So we have to be extra careful with that.
I had no idea. I mean, I've got friends, and please, no one who is as well known as yourself, but friends who sing and sing, you know, they're in bands and popular bands, and they just get on and do it, you know. But I suppose yours is a much finer music, you know, with the opera. You're, like you say, no microphones, no amplification.
Well, rock singers, metal singers, pop singers, they have mics. And they opera singers rely on their whole body to project their voice in an auditorium of 2,000 plus people, sometimes 4,000, like the Metropolitan Opera and other North American houses. So we have to be very close to 100% to be able to sing. And it's really asking for trouble when you're really below par because of sickness and you try to sing over it, because you push your instrument and you risk doing damage. I mean, it's really boring in a way, but it is boring, but what's beautiful about it is the actual singing. I mean, the technicality behind it and the preparation, everything else is pretty boring, but it's a very serious thing. Opera is it is really the highest form, the most elite form of all the performing arts.
Indeed.
Because you have drama, you have theater, you have singing technique and the same thing, plus you have orchestra. So you have, you know, classical music, you have opera singing and drama theater. And it gets very, 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 very demanding. Yes. And sometimes the world, you know, the different worlds of arts, they bridge. Like I was singing at the Metropolitan Opera, Lucia de Lammermoor, it's a Donizetti opera, and James Gray, who's a Hollywood director, movies like Color of the Night.
Cough away.
He called me. He emailed me, and he said, "Hi, I'm James Gray, and you know, I'd like to do a cameo in my next movie with Joaquin Phoenix, Marion Cotillard, and Jeremy Renner." And I thought it was a prank. I mean, I'm like, really? And but it was true. He came to see me at Lucia Lammermoor at the Met, and he wrote to me, and then I emailed back, and I actually did a cameo role in the movie The Immigrant, which will be in Malta in a couple of months. It just debuted in Cannes, and it was kind of surreal to be on the set with, you know, an Oscar-winning actress, Marion Cotillard, you know, Jeremy Renner from The Avengers, Born Supremacy, I guess, and of course, Joaquin Phoenix.
Awesome. And
I was just going to ask. I'm going to nip in there because I've got short memory. But I this is one of the things that had occurred to me when I spoke to you, and also when we were just sort of doing a little bit of research and so on and so forth. Opera to me, I'd never thought that it could be acting and singing. You always just think it's singing. So how much of opera, because obviously you act as well, how much of opera is the acting and the singing? And do you get people who are really good singers but can't act to save their lives? Do you know what I mean? It never occurred to me.
It's very true. I mean, you have singers that are better singers than actors, and you have singers that are better actors than singers. I mean, it happens. Mm-hmm. But in opera, I still like to think that singing is the most important part of it.
Okay.
But being credible as a lover, if you're playing lover, for example, or the warrior, if you're playing your warrior, it's very important. I mean, Sir Laurence Olivier, he said, 80% of acting is looking the role. And I think that's true also for opera. Mm. And there is actually a lot of acting in it. And sometimes it's pretty intense. Mm. I mean, when you have a new production, which means a new interpretation of any given operatic piece, you know, you have 6 weeks of rehearsals for the acting, because the singing is pretty much what it is.
Mm.
Great. Okay. Guys, I've got to play some music, but we're in the studio today on TFI Friday with Joseph Calleja, special guest. It's TFI Friday, of course. It's a Friday. What are you doing? Get in touch. And if you want to ask Joseph a question, you can get in touch as well. Live at one.com.mt. On the SMS, 5061 5011.
And guys, go onto the Facebook page, facebook.com/oneradio Malta. And we're sitting here. We're waiting for you to get in touch. Had a great time last night, people writing in. Do it again this evening. Your beers can wait.
Get in touch. And we've got brand new music from James Arthur up next on One.
Malta's pride on the FM dial. 92.7 FM. One Radio.
James Arthur, you're nobody until somebody loves you. One Radio 92.7, it's TFI. Hi, good evening, I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
And we're joined by a very special guest, Joseph Calleja. Hey, dude, all right?
Hello?
People don't call you dude, I bet.
Sometimes they do.
Sometimes they do. That's okay, then. I thought I was going to get a left hook for a moment.
I've gotten into a nasty habit in the past month of calling absolutely everybody dude. I don't know if I picked it up in Australia and I've just come back, but...
Oh, dude.
Yeah. Oh, dude. Oh, that's what it... You know what it was? I swam with turtles and I had it going over my head all the time, Finding Nemo. So I keep going, oh, dude.
You swam with turtles.
Yeah. I need to get away from this story, don't you? Okay. I've got something for you.
Okay, so I want to play... Can we play False or Trudy?
That's what I've got for you.
Awesome.
Look at that. We're on the same wavelength.
Tell me. So, False or Trudy, what's it all about?
So, it's either false...
Yeah.
or...
Could have guessed.
It's Trudy.
Awesome.
There you go. Did you see what I did with that? Isn't that
very
excellent?
Very
clever.
I've
got a little fact for you both this evening. I want to know whether you think it's false or Trudy. And the fact is, termites eat wood twice as fast when listening to heavy metal music.
Okay. If it's anything like
one.
Me when I'm driving, I'd say true D. You know?
Well, they will have little cars. How does that work?
Just, it speeds up. Well, there's other things that tend to speed up with rock and roll, but we can't talk about them on the radio. Joseph, false or Trudy?
Termites eat wood faster.
When listening to rock and roll.
Mm-hmm.
I mean...
Just make a guess.
Can I phone a friend?
Yes. Or you can go 50-50. That'll work.
I think it's false.
You think it's false?
Yeah.
Okay. What do you think at home? Get in touch. Let us know. Live at one.com.mt on the emails or 5061 5011 on the SMS. It's 58 cent.
And definitely get in touch with us on Facebook, facebook.com/OneRadioMalta.
If you've got a question for Joseph, you can let us know that as well. But false or Trudy once again, Trudes?
Termites eat wood twice as fast when listening to heavy metal.
Oh, it's twice as... It's not just faster.
No, it's twice as fast.
Right, that makes a huge difference
to
how I calculate my answer.
Munching things going away there.
Termites don't have ears. I mean, that's just the whole point.
That's a really good point.
Really good point.
So it's like... If it's vibrations, I don't know, but termites don't have ears, so that's the whole thing.
If they did have ears, surely all they'd be able to hear is their munching of the wood. It would just be...
How do we know they don't have ears?
Well, Joseph's a secret termite specialist.
I have seen a termite before. I couldn't spot the ears.
Okay, so false or Trudy, get in touch with the show. It's TFI Friday. Good evening. 20 minutes to 8. Time flies when you're having fun. We've got music from Clanker Russell coming up. Also, Rizzle Kicks. New track from Burns with Lies. And I didn't manage to play it yesterday, but I will try my best. I will do everything in my power to get Wilkinson and Afterglow for you today as well. Like I said, 20 minutes to 8. We've got all sorts coming up. We've also got some big tunes from our Year of Request 1990. And, of course, we'll be talking more to Joseph Calleja, all coming up before 8:30 in the show. Hope you're having a good one. Hope you're getting prepared for your weekend.
Woo-hoo!
Right now, Clanker Russell on One. Big tune of the summer, Clanker Russell and Son and Tans, The Sun Don't Shine. Good, eh?
It shines in Malta. My friends have just come over and went, oh my good lord.
Wasn't it hot today? It was really great. Like 29 degrees today.
Do you want the weather reason for that?
The what?
We'll talk about it later.
Okay,
there is a technical reason for that.
But the good thing is, like I've noticed, it's getting darker earlier. So by the time I have to walk to work, times are tough.
Question though, did anybody else notice there was a massive power cut last night? I woke up because there was a power cut.
You woke up because... things turned off.
Well, I... Yeah, no, yeah.
That's weird. That's the
because
opposite to normal.
Yeah, I know, but there's an ambient light outside my bedroom, right? It's a street light.
Or red one.
How do you know where I live? I had never mentioned that to you before. Anyway, and it suddenly got really, really dark. I got up to leave to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night. I absolutely whacked my face. Yeah, there was no ambient
and
light.
In the meantime, she woke me up as well. I was sleeping right next to her, and it was really uncomfortable because
it was you turning out the light, wasn't it?
No, it was someone wakes up and is lying right next to me. I really sort of don't really deal with that well, and. It wasn't so much ambient light which woke me up, but, Trudy.
Trudy stumbling around.
But, no, I did because, then the alarms of all the neighbours were going off.
Yeah.
Excuse me for saying that. It's very mean of you to say that because I told you I wouldn't do it again.
Yeah.
I
love that you're here, Joseph, because I didn't know this, we are, of course, joined by Joseph Calleja in the studio tonight for the show. Good evening. Hope you're having a good night and getting ready for your weekend. Joseph, tell me about the Joseph Calleja Foundation. What is it? What you're trying to do? What's the why did you think this was? You obviously set this up, and what is it to you, really?
Well, it's actually going to be launched this month, officially in a few days, and think of it as a safety net under the safety net.
Okay, okay.
And we're not there to compete with other NGOs. We're there to deal with cases that slip away.
What kind of cases? Go back to the beginning.
With children, for example, sure. Children that are in really difficult backgrounds.
Disadvantaged kids.
But really, we're talking about really desperate cases.
Right.
Cases where, for example, there recently was a case of a child who, did petty crime. And because there's not a place for them to go, they end up in Mount Carmel. Or the prison, or in Corradino, correctional facility, which I think is no place for a child of 12, 11, 13 years
indeed,
of age.
Indeed.
And my foundation, this foundation I have in conjunction with BOV, will deal with these cases. It will assist other NGOs in dealing with these cases and make sure that, as much as possible, no child is left without hope. I think that the one thing I don't forgive, I can understand... and may not tolerate, but let's say I understand any kind of crime almost.
Sure.
Except crimes committed towards the weak.
Yes.
And especially towards children.
Yes.
Children have no defense. Children have no... There are cases in Malta, actually, you'd be surprised how many cases of children that come from really bad backgrounds. And, children of 9, 8 years of age that... have to fend for themselves.
Yeah, have to live an adult's life
because,
and find food.
Because their parents are not taking care of them the way they should. So I like to think that this foundation will be the safety net under the safety net. We're not there to compete with other NGOs. We're there to complement them and help them cope with the situation. And I think that charity begins at home. And this is, I think, the proof of that. And we do have in Malta, surprisingly, quite a number of people, of children, an alarming number of children, that could really do with
some help, a helping
with
hand,
with loads of help.
It really strikes a chord with me. In fact, I was talking about this exact same thing in the car on the way over, and how easy it is to make a massive difference to someone else's destiny and their life just by caring, just by actually putting your hand out. I'm really, really stunned and impressed to hear that you're doing this because it's. You just think about young people who just need something. They need that assistance, and it's just fabulous that you're doing that.
Well, the alarming thing is that most of these kids they think that their life is normality because normality is relative to what you're used to.
Yes,
and you have, for example, children of let's say mothers that are prostitutes or fathers that are drunks
in a position where they can't look after their own children.
Yeah, exactly. substance abusers. And it's shocking that I had a headmistress of a government school tell me, Joseph, can you please come to our school and meet these kids? Because there's so many of them, Kids that haven't eaten in 3 days because they had no food prepared for them. I mean, kids that have not. It's a reality, and it's with us. It's I mean, it's not massive, but it's big enough to be a problem. And
how can people get involved? Like, if the listener thinks this is a great idea, they also feel passionate about it, as you clearly do.
In the coming days, there'll be, of course, a bank account where people can donate.
Great.
And one of the prerequisites I requested from BOV is that every single donation is completely up for scrutiny and review. So any donor would be able to scrutinize his donation, how it was spent, and what portion of it was. You know, I want complete transparencies. I know that recently has been some controversy, for example, like Istrina and stuff like that. I don't want this thing to happen with my foundation. It's totally transparent. We're trying to keep administration costs absolutely down, bare minimum.
And, you're not wasting the money. So most of the money can go straight to the kids, is what you're saying.
Every euro cent that we receive for this will be treating with absolute scrutiny and honesty and make sure it goes where the where the donors wanted to go.
Is there a website or anything that people can check out?
There will be very shortly.
Fantastic.
There will be very shortly, and there'll be events, special events and evenings. And again, this is for Maltese children. This is for really for local children. I mean, it might expand in the future, but right now, really thinking of making sure that in Malta, I mean, everybody says how generous Maltese people are, and everybody says how safe.
And indeed,
family-oriented Malta is, and this is
the flip side of that.
This is really, we're making sure that it remains so.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. When you get all that information, when you are set up, let us know, and we'll tell the listener where they can get in touch and donate some money.
It'll be my pleasure, and thank you in advance.
Absolutely. We'll try to support you as much as we can on that.
Over to me to ask a question.
I want to play one of Joseph's songs, but if you have a question.
I think let's play the song first, because I'm still thinking about it.
Joseph, this is your choice from your songs. Tell us about it.
It's my tribute to Edith Piaf, and it's La Vie en Rose. It's a timeless classic, and I think what you're playing is from actually from a live performance. Is it from the Malta one or from the Hyde Park?
I'm not sure. Let's talk about it afterwards.
Okay.
Joseph Clare in the studio here at TFI Friday at La Vie en Rose. I hope I pronounced it right.
Yeah, perfect.
For you right now. Good evening. Hope you're having a good night.
De cela qui j'appartiens. Quand je l'entends dans mes bras, je lui parle tout bas, je vois la vie en rose. Je lui dis des mots d'amour. Et ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'était pour moi, pour elle dans la vie. Je lui aperçois, alors je sens en moi mon cœur qui bat. Des nuits d'amour qui prend sa place, les ennuis, les chagrins s'effacent, heureux, heureux à mourir. Quand je la prends dans mes bras, je lui pense à moi, mon cœur qui bat. La 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 la.
Joseph Calleja with La Vie en Rose here on TFI Friday. Awesome tune. What was the song about, Joseph?
Well, it's about love. Yeah, you know, it's of course.
Awesome.
I mean, love yours. Yeah.
One of my favourite subjects.
Can I go gushing?
You can.
I'm going to go gushing.
I'm just going to give an update on what's still to come in the show, and then you've got an awesome line of questioning, Trudy.
I have.
We're still going to play Paul's Pucker tune. We're way behind time, but it doesn't matter. I've chosen a tune from 1990. Mm-hmm. Big tune from 1990, because that's our year of request today. I'll be playing that a little bit later on. You've got one as well.
I have.
We've got a brand new feature later on called Weather the Weather.
Do you like it?
It's going to be great.
Do you like it?
At about 15 minutes past 8. It's currently 4 minutes to 8, so we are flying. It's TFI Friday. Hello, I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
And we're joined with Joseph Calleja.
It's so exciting. I have a question. Completely different subject. Last weekend, when we had Trevor here, I heard the guys banting this phrase around rider. When you go to... and I had no idea what this is. Where they said, when you go to your performance, what's your rider? And I sat there. I obviously looked very confused. And then Paul explained to me, it's the thing that you like to have in
you
the
request
dressing
backstage,
room or
your,
whatever.
Your request. Joseph knows what it is.
Like I know, but I'm trying to explain it, and I'm new to all this thing.
So when Amy Winehouse was doing a gig, her rider, which is what she requested backstage, was 25 bottles of Jack Daniels.
Yeah, that's just calm.
I mean, one, fair enough. 25, it's a little bit over-egging it. But
so
yeah.
We had quite a good fun with Trevor about this. I'm going to ask you, Joseph Calleja, what's your rider?
My rider? It's boring and extremely simple, but it's usually chamomile tea with honey. And a few bananas and water. That's it.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's very calm and tame.
It is. But, I mean, many artists, you know, they request flowers and all kinds of things. And they just want to look complicated just for the sake of being complicated. But I'm pretty much straightforward. And I don't need that in my life. So.
You're a lovely guy.
I'm a lovely guy. I'm just who I am. And I think that the thing is this. That I was for a while being represented by different management based in Austria, and they were a bit like used to represent finicky singers, you know, mm-hmm. singers with you know, a list of 35 different
right.
requests in their rider. And my friend, the performance was in Qatar, you know, a Muslim country, of course, and the management, unbeknownst to me, requested ham sandwiches.
And this guy, oh, my word.
And this guy called me and he said, Emad Sultan from Qatar. He said, Joseph, he said, you know, we've prepared your other 25 requests, but you have a problem with your 26. I said, what? and he said, well, you know, it's a Muslim country. We have a problem with ham sandwiches. I'm like, Emad, you know, just ignore that writer. All I need is chamomile tea with honey, which is... and just some water and if possible a banana
and a banana or two.
And he got so grateful that yeah. But I know that many artists have ridiculous riders, and I don't know. I mean, during a performance, you can't possibly consume. You know, a complicated. So yeah, I'm very straightforward. Chamomile tea, honey, water, and a
banana. Fantastic. And you bring me on to the next question, which is we spoke yesterday. You've travelled so much. Where's the place that leaves the biggest impression on you, and where is the place that you haven't been yet that you really want to go? Two questions.
Okay.
It's like a double-barreled shotgun.
Do you like
two
that?
Questions?
I didn't perform it, but I went there for vacation. I love Scotland, the West Highlands.
Oh, really?
I think. Right.
Why are you clapping your hands to that?
My sister married a Scotsman.
Oh, okay. Sorry
okay,
about that.
So, yeah.
Hello, Scotland.
Hello, Scotland. You got a fire burning in my heart. So yeah, Scotland, and that's wonderful. There are many beautiful places, of course, and I love to visit one day Australia.
Australia,
yeah, mate. And I'm just trying to figure out if I still need a criminal record to get in.
Tell me, I've been there twice, you do.
Prisoner of Her Majesty.
Going back to the Scotland question, what was it about Scotland that you really liked? Was it the open space? Was it the Scottish accent? Was it the cold weather?
No, I was there for 3 summers, and don't hate me, but it rarely rained, but I was there. I was in this beautiful, actually it's the estate of Gordon Brown's family. The Kingie estate, northwest of Invergarry, a small village, again northwest of Fort William. And it's just God's country. I mean, I've been to the Alps, you know, the Swiss, the Italian, and the Austrian, and just nothing compares with the drive between Glasgow and Fort William when you go and, you know, and hit the mountains or the Munros, as the Scots call them. It's just spectacular. It's just and I fly fish there and I walk there, and it's just an amazingly beautiful part of the country.
And you're educating me, because it's slightly embarrassing. I'm English. I've never been to Scotland. I hear everybody talking about it's not that funny. I've been everywhere else, but I haven't been there.
And it is a different country. Some people don't realise it's a different country from England. Like Wales. People don't realise
that
Wales.
And they speak a different language.
Yeah, indeed.
Which is crazy.
Me, Scotland. I can't. Basically, I'm as good as the janitor from Simpsons in my Scottish accent.
There you
Willie.
Go.
My name's Willie.
Well, leading on from that, so where's the biggest place you've played? Where's the
biggest gig?
The venue? Where's either the city or whatever? What
it's
meant gotta
be
the
this
most
show.
To you?
It's got
to
be this show, sure. London Opera House, slightly bigger than this show. Slightly bigger than the studio.
I mean, for size, in the Metropolitan Opera, it has an excess of 4,000 seats.
Wow.
But the biggest gig to date is when I sung in Bastille Day. Oh my God, that came out Bastille. It's Bastille Day on the 14th of July, under the Tour of Phil. And we had a live audience of 650,000 people.
Wow.
Live.
That's double Robbie Williams' biggest audience straight away. His biggest is 300,000 at Hyde Park, I think.
Well,
good work.
We had, it was a free concert. We had Lang Lang performing. It was me. There were a couple of other artists. And it was pretty massive.
For great stuff. Look, it's 2 minutes past eight. We're going to play some more music. I've got a couple of texts in first, though. Hi, it's the first time I'm listening to Joseph on the radio. Is this his single? He's a really nice guy. Thank you, Pauline. Hi, Pauline. How are you doing? And also, Joseph Calleja is simply an extraordinary... Hi, Trudy and Paul, first. Joseph Calleja is simply an extraordinary and inspiring person, and he's so natural at singing and performing opera. Great fan of his. Keep up the good work. That's from Sharon in Zabuj. So, good work. Hi, Sharon.
Hey, Sharon.
Hey, it's time is flying. We've got great music coming up for you. We're going to play a bit of Bastille and Things We Lost in the Fire. It's a great track. Next, here on One.
Malta's pride on the FM dial. 92.7 FM. One Radio.
Oh, that I adore.
Is that it? Bastille, The Things We Lost in the Fire. One Radio. 92.7. Good evening. I didn't expect it to end like that. That frightened me. It's TFI Friday. Hi, I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
And we're joined with Joseph Calleja in the studio. If you want to get in touch and ask him a question, do so. Live at one.com.mt or on the SMS 5061 5011. It's 58 cent.
Or Bob us a Facebook message. Come and tell us what the questions are. We're right here on the Facebook. It's facebook.com/OneRadioMalta.
Trudy, I need to know whether it's false or true.
Remind me. Okay, the question again is, termites eat wood twice as fast when listening to heavy metal music. Now, you said...
I said Vera. No, I didn't. I said Trudy. I'm mixing up shows.
And, Joseph, what was yours?
I don't think termites have ears. They might sense vibration, but don't have ears.
So
okay.
So you're
saying it's a false.
What is
so
it?
So we have... hang on a second. We have...
I'll tell you what, let's get some music
Rita,
going for
John,
this.
Josephine and Robert all saying that it's false, but we have Tony, Charlotte, Floyd, Doris, Simone, Miranda and Maria saying it's Trudy.
Oh, Trudy, okay.
Okay, I'm going to tell you what it is.
Okay, go.
I'm going to give you the answer. When termites eat, they tear at wood fibres. This makes a sound in the wood. The sound varies a lot, but we know they prefer eating big bits of wood. But if the wood is already vibrating from sound, it can change their behaviour.
Hold on.
I said that very quickly, didn't I? Let's get to the very important bit.
What?
When they hear the sound,
yeah,
and it makes a vibration, it changes their behavior. It's true. Termites eat wood twice as fast when listening to heavy metal music.
Unbelievable.
It vibrates through their bodies, basically.
1-0 to me, Joseph.
but that's not listening. That's a vibration. It's different. So if you can emulate the same vibration as heavy metal music, then you have the same thing. So
see, of course, Joseph, you're an expert.
Technically, Joseph is right.
He is right, isn't he? How do I always lose these competitions?
You're not doing so good at the minute on that.
For more false or Trudy, join us next Friday for the 7 o'clock for the TFI Friday. Sorry, I'm all over the place tonight. We'll be back, of course, at 7 o'clock next Friday. But right now, it's this Friday. We've got Joseph Calleja in the studio. We've only got another 20 minutes left of the show. But Joseph, I really want to ask you about Adormidera. Tell us, new film out, made in Malta. It's homegrown.
Yeah. it's really, I mean, you can't really compare it to the, you know, the big Hollywood epic movies. It just didn't have the budget. And I actually seen the premiere, and I think that it's a very promising start to what I hope will be the evolution of
film in Malta.
Film in Malta.
Sure.
I think that the indoor filming, especially the attention to detail, the costume, and the indoor location, especially, were quite exceptional.
Great.
Of course, if you compare it to Troy, Gladiator, and all that, it will not hold its ground. But for a Maltese production, for kind of as a calling card to what might be the future of Maltese film, it's pretty an outstanding achievement.
So you're setting a standard, and you're trying to up the bar a bit of film made in Malta.
Well, I'm not an actor, you know. I was just there to support my friend
Andre.
What
was your role? What was your role?
I was a blacksmith,
right.
In a movie, and I had my kids acting in it too, and they loved it, you know, and they loved seeing themselves in the big screen in Eden. It really was fun. I mean, I just filmed for a couple of hours, and but it was fun, and it's, you know, it's always nice to support something which is predominantly Maltese.
Yeah, of course. So you don't sing in it?
I do.
You do sing in it?
Yeah, of course.
Because I haven't seen it, of course, because I've seen the advert. You can see it on YouTube. Adormidera is the name if you want to look it up. But yeah. tell us, it's a dual-skilled role.
I'm singing, whilst hammering a sword
brilliant.
In a furnace. I'm singing a 14th century song, actually, which is actually really from the 14th century.
It's going to be in cinemas.
So PRS don't have any claim on that.
Exactly. No copyright fees
there.
Exactly.
The problem is I've got now pictures of you as a blacksmith singing, "All I want is a room somewhere." I can't stop that.
That's not 14th century.
No, I know. I realise that.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. That was a blonde moment from the girl over here.
Yeah, many of them this evening. Yeah.
when is it going to be in the cinemas? When can we see it?
It's just right now.
Right now. Yeah, so at the all the big cinemas in Malta, we can see Adormidera. Go and buy a ticket. Starring Joseph Calleja.
No. I am just a cameo role, okay? It's not starring me. I'm a very short role in the movie, but it's starring Andre Claude, a very good friend of mine, Audrey Harrison, and other really good Maltese actors.
Fantastic.
You talked about acting on cameo roles and so on and so forth. Is that something you'd like to do more of? Would you like to do more acting?
Mm.
No.
That was a nice, quick, short
answer. I'm an opera singer first and foremost. If the occasional cameo role comes ahead and I'm free, I'll do it. But actually, some trivia for you. Woody Allen wanted me to star, do a role which is pretty actually chunky in his latest film, From Rome With Love. I couldn't due to us, you know, conflict in my schedule, but that was really flattering because and then it went to my very good colleague Fabio Armiliato, who did the role. But that was pretty much a big role, and I'm kicking myself that I couldn't do it, but unfortunately
that's
I had signed
amazing.
A contract for something else.
Yeah. Well, it must be like that in the industry that you work in. Sometimes you must be able to not do roles, a conflict of dates, maybe booking dates. What's the biggest role you've turned down, or the most, what's the word I'm looking for? Biggest disappointment to you of turning down a role? Is there anything you thought, I really wish I could have done that?
Just this movie, I think, because in opera it's different. I mean, the occasion always comes back somehow in the future seasons.
Because
we're booked 5-6 years in advance. So
wow.
Whoa.
So you know today that you've got 5 years of work ahead of you.
If I'm still alive, yes.
Great. Yeah. That's great. I don't know if I've got a job tomorrow.
I'm booked out till the end of 2018, which is kind of nice.
Fantastic. Yeah. So we can't book you if we need to book you.
Well, for short, I mean, for things that don't require long periods, you absolutely can. But it's not impressive. It's just the nature of
of the industry. When you're in Malta, obviously, it's your home.
Yeah.
But you said earlier that you flew in a few days ago, less than a week. You've got to fly out again soon. So when you're here, do you make the most of it? What do you do? See your mates, see your family, or...?
First and foremost are my kids.
Kids, of course,
I have absolutely really good friends. And I enjoy my boat.
Very nice.
And I enjoy the sea as much as possible. But quiet things, not usually much partying, because it doesn't really go with, good for my voice. I mean, and... yeah, just really aggressive stuff. Nothing out of, nothing extraordinary.
Nothing, no bungee jumping or skydiving?
When you're relaxing, time off?
No.
No.
No. Fair enough, can't argue with that. You've talked about Woody Allen and you've talked about, and we've talked about who you've sung with as well. I mean, of all the people that you've worked with, who is the one person that really sticks in your mind that you've sung with or whatever you've done that you would love to work with again?
I've met some pretty impressive people. I mean, Henry Kissinger, George Bush Sr., Clint Eastwood, Russell Crowe, Roger Federer. I mean, it was surreal when I watched the final Wimbledon, I think it was 2009, and I was sitting next to Federer's parents. That was kind of cool, and I had Woody Allen and Matthew Modine and Russell Crowe a couple of seats to my right, and I was just a guest of Rolex, and of course Rolex is sponsor for but the one time I was really starstruck, I think, was at the Kennedy Center Awards when I met Clint Eastwood. He's just as scary and piercing as he is, in the Dirty Harry series.
Really?
Did you speak to him?
I did, yeah, absolutely.
Is he a nice guy? does he actually talk properly? Does he always talk like that?
You know, like, Clint Eastwood, he's a legend, really, isn't he? If you're going to talk about big stars.
It was like, yeah, let's get over this so I can hit the links. He loves golf.
Brilliant. What a legend.
Fantastic.
Winning an award. Oh, quick, no, let's go and play some golf. Fantastic. 17 minutes past 8. Good evening. If you just joined us, it's at TFI Friday. Hi, I'm Paul.
And I'm Trudy.
We're joined by Joseph Calleja in the studio. We've only got 13 minutes left. That's Trudy's singing voice, by the way. We've only got 13 minutes left, so we're going to play some music. We'll come back to you, Joseph, in just a second. Bit more music, and we've got to go. I suppose it is Friday.
Yes.
Indeed. What music should we play? Oh, I know. Let's play a bit of Rizzle Kicks. Great new tune at the moment. Hope you're enjoying your Friday night. It's Lost Generation, One Radio 92.7. Good evening.
I said I'm living in a lost generation. I said I'm living in a lost generation. I said I'm living in a lost
Rizzle Kicks, Lost Generation. Almost at the end of our show now. It's me, Paul, joined by...
Trudy.
And... Joseph Calleja in the studio.
I love that track because every time it comes on, we dance like crazy, crazy people.
Yeah, I know. I when I'm dancing, I don't pay much attention to anyone else. But I noticed when I stopped dancing that I could pay attention to you. And it was an experience, I tell you.
I love the fact that Joseph looked at us and went, oh my good grief, what are those two doing?
21 minutes past 8, good evening. It's One Radio, 92.7. And really, just all we've got time for, guys, is to say goodbye. Is there anything else you wanted to ask Joseph before he runs away and thinks I'm never coming back to see them two again?
Yeah, what are you doing tonight?
Back to the red light.
Yeah, well,
it's on.
It's on, yeah.
Ting is Super One listeners, that she actually means it.
brilliant. Oh dear. So listen, the film's coming out. If you've been listening tonight and you want to know more about that, Adore Madeira, look it up on YouTube first, see the trailer, and it's in cinemas now, Joseph, yes?
Yes,
it's in cinemas now. Great stuff. I've kind of got one last question for you. You said when you've got your time off, you like to just relax. And when you're on the road, how much time do you get to relax? I mean, do you really get to sit, kick back in, or is it always on planes, off planes, moving on?
Or is it a mix
of
the
both? Sometimes it is like that. It sounds glamorous, it isn't. It's just lots of, nice hotels, but still just hotels. And yeah. But it's you know, some people are soldiers and they're stationed in Afghanistan or Iraq and they have to, you know, they risk life and limb. I don't risk life and limb. Having said that, when I was singing in Houston, I did meet a couple of veterans, and one of them was a lovely woman from Houston, and she was in Iraq, and she was shot at and hit, you know, and she was showing me scars. And I said, well, next Saturday I'm singing at the opera, why don't you come and see me? She said, sure, okay. So I've arranged a ticket. And I sung, and was Madame Butterfly of Puccini.
Right.
And she told me, you know what, Joseph, I would rather, you know, face insurgents in Iraq shooting at me than facing an audience like that for 3 hours and do what you do. Which, well, I'd rather sing than, you know, than risking my life. But it just takes some courage to expose yourself that way, in a way. So, but my life is pretty tough on my road, but it has... It's you know, beautiful moments. You know, I have dined with Colin Powell. I have dined with Henry Kissinger. I have met President Bush. You know, I have met actors. You know, I have met and it's you really meet the best people in the world occasionally, and even that alone, it just enriches you. It's not because it's impressive. It's just because usually these statues. I mean, like a couple of weeks ago, I was at the Amnesty International. There was Bono, and there was.
Did Roger you get to chat to Bono?
Yeah,
much?
I did.
Is he all right?
You know, Bono and The Edge and Roger Waters, and there was Malala, you know, and the Pakistani girl who was shot and survived. And there was Harry Belafonte, who's pretty much, you know, we gave them the Ambassador of Conscience Award, which is the highest award that Amnesty International gives out.
So what you're saying is it's almost impossible to get frustrated with your situation because so many good things are there that help you to just be happy.
No, it can be frustrating occasionally, but, I mean, life is like that.
Yeah, and life
is. Also, it's also frustrating to go to a mundane job from, you know, Monday to Friday from 8 to 5.
Yeah, sure.
So everything has its pros and cons, and but then again, what I do at this level, I'm like one of five in the world, and that's just gives you so much responsibility, but also a sense of really being thankful. I do what I love.
Yeah.
How many people can say that?
Absolutely. I mean, yeah. Absolutely.
Well, listen, thank you so much for taking your time out to come on the show. I'm really. You know, excited. I had a great time listening to you and talking to you. It's been fantastic. But thank you for taking the time out.
And it's been really great to see another side, Joseph. You know, to like to just get to know you as a person instead of you on stage. So, again, from me, thank you. That's pretty much all we've got time for. We've got one more text in. Well done, Joseph. It's true. Charity begins at home. Children are tomorrow's backbone. We'll definitely support you. It's so nice that a person like you is in touch with the cruel reality. You know, we know what you mean. Unfortunately, his children are hurt physically and worse emotionally. So she's really supporting the Joseph Calleja Foundation. And as Joseph gets more information about that and they start to put it together, we'll have the information here for you on One as well. So you'll know how to get involved and help out the foundation for the children in Malta. Joseph, once again, thank you so much for coming in. Thank you. It's been a great show. Okay, so our last song then. What should we go out with? I did have one here.
Make it a goodie.
It will be. Don't worry. It's Friday night. It's got to be a goodie. It's the brand new one from Fatboy Slim, actually. He's back with his song Eat, Sleep, Rave, Repeat.
How frightfully lovely.
We'll be back Thursday.
We will.
7 o'clock for the 7 o'clock show.
Imaginative title.
We'll see
you then.
Good night. Ciao, ciao. Jeez, thank